السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واهلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. We begin with the praises that belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His assistance, and we beg for His forgiveness. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace, mercy and blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon His beloved family members, upon His beloved companions and upon all of us and our family members. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless me in my speech, to remove the defects of my tongue, to make my task easy for me and bless me and grace me even more out of His grace and mercy so that all of you can understand my speech. Alhamdulillah, my dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to yet another episode of the Iman Boosters, and I hope and pray that you are enjoying these short videos, and inshallah ta'ala, if you are, then do not forget to share, inshallah. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, today's hadith, subhanallah, it is absolutely mind-blowing. This is one of my favorite hadith. Why? Because it is so easy, because we do it in every single day of our life. We are indulged in this beautiful hadith. All we need to do is pay attention to some minute details and the reward is absolutely mind-blowing, subhanallah. Yes, today we will learn something amazing to boost our iman, to inspire us to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to inspire us to do something better for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Him, and then towards the end, earn the reward of Jannah and Jannatul Firdaus. Allahu Akbar. So my dearest brothers and sisters, remember, these are really simple actions that you and I will learn, but the reward cannot be measured, but can only be treasured, inshallah ta'ala. So let's learn today's beautiful hadith, which is collected by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, and it is narrated by Uqba ibn Amir radiallahu anhu, who narrated that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam was standing and giving this message. But before this, he says, we all were entrusted, you know, some of the Sahabas were entrusted by taking care of the camels. So he says that on this day, it was my turn. And the reason I'm mentioning the first part of this hadith is because he missed the first part. He missed something in this hadith, right? So he only got the second part of this hadith and he narrated the second part. And there's another companion who narrated the first part of the hadith, and I want to bring both the hadith to you, inshallah, in today's class, which is absolutely mind-blowing, subhanallah. So he says that we all were entrusted with tending camels, meaning taking care of camels, and it was my turn. Uqba ibn Amir, it was his turn. And he says, so when I came back in the evening, when I finished my task of taking care of grazing the camels and so on, I noticed that Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I found him standing and addressing the people. He was addressing the people. So he went and sat in that gathering, and he heard Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying these words, and he says, "Ma min Muslim." There is not a single Muslim, meaning every one of you, who يَتَوَدَّأُ فَيُحْسِنُ, the one who makes wudu and perfects it, meaning he makes it with excellence. We all make wudu, subhanallah. 5 times, 6 times, subhanallah, we all make wudu in a day, right? وُضُوءَهُ, and he makes his wudu with perfection. ثُمَّ يَقُومُ فَيُصَلِّي رَكَتَيْنِ, then he stands and prays 2 rak'at. So he finishes his wudu and then he goes and stands and prays 2 rak'ats. مُقْبِلٌ عَلَيْهِمَا, meaning focusing attention, you know, complete his attention with 2 things is prime. What are they? قَبْلِهِ, his heart, وَوَجْهِهِ, his face. So Allah's Messenger is saying that this person, the Muslim who makes wudu and he performs it really well, he then prays 2 rak'ats. All right. So now he's technically missed the first part of the hadith, by the way. He's missed the first part of the hadith. So this is the second part of the hadith that he's narrating. So this man makes wudu. Anyone who makes wudu prays 2 rak'ats and he focuses his attention, his concentration with his heart, mind and face is absolutely crystal clear for the sake of Allah in that salah. What does Allah's Messenger say? Subhanallah. He says, wajabat. He said, with his heart and his face, إِلَّا وَجَبَتْ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. Except that Jannah is wajib on him. Subhanallah. Wajib comes from wajabat. Wajabat means Jannah has become guaranteed, compulsory. Imagine Allah's Messenger is saying, when you make two rak'ats after performing beautiful wudu and praying with focus, concentration, attention, and seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's it. Nothing else. Seeking the reward from Allah. Allah guarantees, He has set a seal. He says, Jannah is wajib on that person. Whether male or female, subhanAllah. Anyone. Ma min Muslim. It's not a male only. He says anyone, subhanAllah. And then this the beautiful sahaba, Uqba bin Amir radiallahu anhu, when he was sitting, he says, subhanAllah. He says, this is amazing. This hadith is beautiful, subhanAllah. And somebody who was sitting in front, he heard Uqba saying that this hadith is beautiful. And the person sitting in front said, do you know what he said before this? And Uqba said, no, tell me, I don't know. So this man in front said that, I see that you have just arrived and you missed the first part of the hadith. So Uqba radiallahu anhu, what does he do? He peeps in. He peeps who this man is. And this man is none other than Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Subhanallah. Umar is sitting in front of Uqba. And Uqba comes in late. He listens to the second part of the hadith and he misses the first part. So now Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he narrates this first part that he missed. And what does he say? Subhanallah. He says, ma minkum min ahadin. He says, subhanallah, there is nobody amongst you. Nobody amongst you that yatawadda'u fayubligu alwudu'a, that he performs wudu and he completes it with what, fayuhsin, with absolute beauty, with excellence, meaning he does not leave any part without putting water on it. He does not, neglect any part of his wudu, and he's there performing wudu with the most beautiful ways. Thumma yaqul. In the other hadith, in the first part, Allah's Messenger says, ثُمَّ يَقُومُ فَيُصَلِّ رَكَتَيْنِ. Then he stands and prays two rakats. But in this hadith, Allah's Messenger said, Umar ibn al-Khattab said, Rasulullah said, ثُمَّ يَقُولُ أَشْهَدُ أَن لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ, that he bears witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his slave and final messenger. Allahu Akbar. So Umar says, I'll repeat this again. This man enters late. He hears Allah's Messenger saying, the one who makes wudu and makes it really beautiful, stands and prays two rakats, for him Jannah is guaranteed. Subhanallah. Umar radiallahu anhu says that you missed the first part. He says, what's the first part? He says, the one who makes wudu and he makes it really well. And then he says, so meaning, when you finish wudu, before you pray two rakats, you say this. What? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. We all know this beautiful kalimat. I bear witness there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and final messenger. What does Allah's Messenger say? Allahu Akbar. Illa futihat lahu al-abwaab al-jannah. How many? Except that the gates of Jannah will open. How many? One, two. We know Jannah has eight gates, subhanAllah. And unfortunately, because of the COVID-19 situation, we could not have the Eid Salah like usual. And subhanAllah, my topic for this time's Eid was taking on the eight gates of Jannah. So Allah's Messenger وسلم, says, إِلَّا فُتِحَتْ لَهُ الْأَبْوَابَ الْجَنَّةَ الثَّمَانِيَةُ. All the eight gates of Jannah will be opened. Subhanallah. Just for the person who makes excellent wudu and says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Yes, there is also, Allahumma ja'alni min at-tawwabina wa ja'alni min al-mutatahirin. Oh Allah, make me from those who repent and those who are pure. Wudu makes you clean. Wudu purifies you. But the one who says the shahada, all the eight gates of Jannah will be open. يَدْخُلُوا مِنْ أَيْهَا شَاءَ. Allahu Akbar. And Allah's Messenger says, he may enter from the gate he wishes. Allahu Akbar. He may enter from the gate he wishes. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanallah al-azim. Allahu Akbar. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, just imagine that how much Allah loves a person doing wudu. How much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves testifying there is no God deity worthy of worship but Allah. How much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that you bear witness on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much Allah loves that you perform two rakats only for seeking His face, subhanallah. Wudu, shahada, and salah. Three things. What is the outcome? 8 gates of Jannah being opened, you choosing any gate to enter, and Jannah is wajib upon you. Subhanallah. Can it get better? Subhanallah. I want to ask you, can it get better? Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. So my dearest brothers and sisters, next time when you make wudu, do two things. One, fa'ahsin, make it really well. And pray two rakats seeking the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and never forget reciting the shahadatain after completing wudu. My dearest brothers and sisters, before I would like to end, wudu is a great topic that you can study. A lot of us, trust me, 90% of people amongst the Muslim nation have just grown up learning wudu or seeing wudu from different people or from their parents, but they've never sat down and opened a book of fiqh and studied how to perform the wudu like Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Take the hadith of Uthman bin Affan radiallahu anhu, where he practically, physically showed how Allah's Messenger made wudu. And then he says, this is how Allah's Messenger made wudu. Brothers and sisters, for a small example, I would like to give, many people do the back of the neck, which is not even there as a part of the wudu, which is not even a sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salam. So I'm just giving you small examples of how we have deviated away from the path of Allah's Messenger. Learn, spend some time, because it is a matter of your 8 gates of Jannah. It is a matter of that Allah seals Jannah for you. That's what Allah is talking about. So I'm sure we can spend 15 minutes going through the ways of performing wudu of the Prophet alayhi salam. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, in the end, I would only like to ask you a question. If the eight gates are opened for you, think again, which gate would you like to enter? Subhanallah. Don't forget to share this video with this. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.